This next song requires a boot. If you're one of those people that finds the sort of bashing of religion and stuff tiresome or offensive, just give me 5 more minutes.
Life is like an ocean voyage, and our bodies are the ships. And without a moral compass, we would all be cast adrift. So to keep us on our bearings, the Lord gave us a gift. And like most gifts you get, it was a book. I only read one book, but it's a good book, don't you know? I act the way I act because the good book tells me so. If I wanna know how to be good, it's to the good book that I go. Cause the good book is a book and it is good and it's a book. I know the good book's good because the good book says it's good. I know the good book knows it's good because a really good book would. You wouldn't cook without a cookbook, and I think it's understood. You can't be good without a good book because it's good and it's a book and it is good for cooking. I tried to read some other books, but I soon gave up on that. The paragraphs ain't numbered and they complicate the facts. I can't read Harry Potter because they're worshipping false gods and that. And Dumbledore's a poofter, and that's bad because it's not good. Morality is written there in simple white and black. I feel sorry for your heathens, got to think about all that. Good is good and evil's bad, and goats are good and pigs are crap. You'll find which one is which in the good book, because it's good and it's a book and it's a book. Yeah, I had a cat, she gave birth to a litter. The kittens were adorable and they made my family laugh, but as they grew they started misbehaving, so I drowned the little fuckers in the bath. When the creatures in your care start being menaces, the answers can be found right there in Genesis. Chapter 6, verse 5 to 7. Yeehaw! Swing your partner by the hand. Have a baby if you can. But if the voices in your head say to sacrifice your kid to satiate your loving God's fetish for dead baby blood, it's simple faith the book demands. So raise that knife up in your hands. Before the good book made us good, there was no good way to know if a thing was good or not that good or kind of touch and go. So God decided he'd give writing allegoric prose a go. And so he wrote a book and it was generally well received. The Telegraph said this God is reminiscent of the Norse. The Times said kind of turgid, but I liked a bit with horses. The Mail said lots of massacres, a violent tour de force. If you only read one book this year, then this one is a book, and it is good, and it's a book. Yeehaw! Swing your daughter by the hand, but if she gets raped by a man and refuses then to marry him, stone her to death. Just close your eyes and block your ears to the accumulated knowledge of the last 2,000 years. Then morally, guess what? You're off the hook. And thank Christ you only have to read one book. Just because the book's contents were written generations hence by hairy desert-dwelling gents squatting in their dusty tents. Just because what heaven said was said before they'd leavened bread. Just because Jesus couldn't read doesn't mean that we should need manipulating human genes to alleviate pain or fight disease. When deciding whether it's wrong or right to help the dying let go of life or to stop a pregnancy when it's just a tiny blastocyst, there's no reason why we should take a look at any other book but the good book, cause it's good and it's a book and it's a book and it's quite good. Ooh! Whoa. Fuck, that's fucked.